invite the guest of honor of this particular session, but before that, I would like to request my technical team to kindly relay the film made on the life of Dr. Sushil Sharma ji.
Dr. Sushil Sharma is currently an associate dean and a professor of computer information systems in the Miller College of Business at Ball State University. Dr. Sharma has a unique distinction of earning two doctoral degrees. He has over two decades of administrative leadership experience and more than 25 years of experience in higher education. Prior to joining the faculty at Ball State, he held the associate professor position at the Indian Institute of Management, Lucknow, and was a visiting research associate professor at the Department of Management Science at the University of Waterloo, Canada. His primary research interests are in computer information systems security, e-learning, e-government, computer mediated communications, human-computer interaction, and community and social informatics. He has taught several graduate and undergraduate courses on a variety of subjects, including database management, ERP systems, electronic commerce, and computer and network security. He is also the founding editor-in-chief of the International Journal of E-Adoption. We are honored to welcome Dr. Sushil Sharma.
Please welcome with a big round of applause the guest of honor of this session, Dr. Sushil Sharma ji.
Very good afternoon. I'm grateful to Dr. Vishwanath Karad and Rahul Karadji making me a part of this event. And over the last 2 days, I met wonderful people from all over the world who shared their experiences, which has enriched my own experiences, which I'm going to cherish in future. Dignitaries on the dais, off the dais, and my fellow faculty colleagues from all over the world. In these 8 to 10 minutes, I'm going to share the first part, the evolution of technology, how it's evolving, and more so in education area. And the second part, I'm going to share my own experiences of how I have embraced technology both for teaching as well as for my own learning. And hope at the end of the 10 minutes, there could be a few takeaways with your experiences. So let me begin with throwing some of the terminologies. I'm sure you have heard the word called Industry 4.0. This is the big buzzword going around, Industry 4.0. Industry 4.0 is nothing but the industrial revolution of the fourth version. And before I come there, let me just explain that before industrial revolution, which began in 17th century, prior to that, we always had agriculture-based economy. So the real documentation of industrial revolution began in 17th century and lasted for 100 years till 1840. And that was termed in the literature Industry 1.0. After 1840, we entered into Industry 2.0. And what was the difference? Industry 1.0 had more use of mechanical systems, machines, for production as well as for economy. Industry 2.0 augmented with electrical, electronics, electromagnetic systems, again for production and economy. was not much of literature for industrial 1.0 and 1.2, but the big revolution came in form of industrial 3.0, which began somewhere again after 100 years in 1940 onwards. And that was an era or a century of electronic and computers and internet revolution, which was termed as Industry 3.0. And that is going through, but literature already have started coming out with this word that from 2010 onwards, we are entering into Industry 4.0. So let me a little bit elaborate the difference between Industry 3.0 and Industry 4.0. In Industry 3.0, various technologies took place, various innovation happened, but I'm limiting my mention of only computers and internet, which changed the way we live, we learn, and the way we do business. So in the era of internet, which began in early 80s or late 80s, suddenly you saw some of the terms appearing, web technologies. So I'm going to limit my discussion mainly on the web technologies because this has a very, very strong impact on education. So as part of the third industrial revolution, the first web 1.0 stage came when we started using learning management softwares for our education. And that era was basically posting the static information on the website. Then came Web 2.0, which was more bi-directional, where now we started interacting with students through the chat forums, discussion forums, and it became a more transactional with all e-commerce or online transactions. Web 3.0 started somewhere in 2005 onwards, where now web has a capability of capturing 3D environments, 3D technologies, to create a fully 3D virtual environment, which has a long impact on in education or in e-learning. And even we are passing through this age when suddenly this Industry 4.0 have started. So just quick experience. I, as a teacher, way back in 1990 to 2000, I started posting my material online in the learning management software, using learning management software like Blackboard, WebCT. In 2000 onward, this learning management software had a feature of discussion forums, chat forums. So my engagement with the students' learning became much more on 24/7 basis. In e-learning 3.0, after 2005 onwards, till today, what I do, that not only I engage with the students from all over the world, just to mention, every year I teach around 6 to 8 courses in 6 to 8 universities worldwide from my bedroom or from my home. This itself is the huge impact of technology in education field. That I have a privilege to teach in places like Kabul. I just finished a course last week, MBA course, teaching students in Kabul, students in Istanbul, students in New Zealand, students in Denmark. And that itself is a living example of how technology has changed the landscape of education. I call it from chalkboards to chatboards. So now, not only I interact with the students through these learning management softwares, but just to assess how they are using this, I use the back end, which we call BEB analytics. I use the back end and see how many students, for how much time, they have opened these slides or some of the material which I have posted. Not only that, which part of the slide or which part of the document they have spent more time. So I'm trying to find out what interested them most. And probably trying to create a customized learning which may be more needed. Because gone are the days when faculty used to go with one agenda in the classroom and see, okay, this is what I have agenda, this is what I will deliver. We are in the era of education where it is more student-centered, it's more learner-centered, so we, and it is more personalized learning environment. So we have to cater to the needs of the various learners who have a different learning styles. So I try to see what they are interested. In fact, right in the beginning of the class, I asked students, what are the 5 takeaways you want to take out of this class? And if there are 50 students in a class, and I get 250 questions, my first task is to answer these 250 questions with good examples and applied projects, and make it available to all the to the whole class as a frequently asked question repository or knowledge repository. And I see this, that if I'm able to cater to their needs, the 5 takeaways, probably I have met the goals of my course, providing them more personalized or customized learning. Now, let's see this technology, how it is changing the landscape of higher education. First, globalization, which we had a topic yesterday in the very first session, is the outcome of the technology use in education. As I mentioned, I teach in 7 to 8 different countries, so I have a global audience. Now, when I go in teaching in these courses, I'm also aware of that these courses would be available worldwide. So I have to meet those standards, so I'm trying to see that the way I present my content in the class meet the best standards of the world. So the global audience, the global opportunity, that's the first paradigm shift in education. Dr. Dhande mentioned the use of MOOCs or Khan Academy in our academics. Look at, you as a student and me as a faculty have an opportunity to learn from the number of different professors who have been teaching courses on these subjects for our own learning or enriching our own experiences and sharing with the student. That's the first paradigm shift which is taking place out of the technology used in education. The second paradigm shift is happening in terms of virtualization. Everything is virtual. I teach a course and there I have started now using what we call flipped classroom, because what I do when I record my lectures, I'm also aware of that students on their side not only should get this content but able to use it for real life application. So I create some videos using YouTube and other digital tools and make it available to students. And these, like MOOCs and Coursera courses, are available around the world for people to use it. So virtualization is the second part. I use one technology which many of you must have used it, called Google Box. It's just a $20 device. And there are plenty of 3D environment-based application on your smartphone. And students not only can see, so in future or in next year we can experiment, that students sitting any parts of the world using Google Boxes can see this proceeding as if they are here. So when they move along with the application, they can experience as if physically they are here. And those are the technology we are trying to bring in education to enrich the learning experiences of students. And that's the Second paradigm shift. Third paradigm shift, which I realize over the years, students are becoming like partners, co-constructor of knowledge. The responsibility of creating knowledge is not only with us, but it's with everybody, and that's the third paradigm shift. And the last paradigm shift is that instead of a speed, the emphasis on velocity. So when you teach a course, how much value-adding activities you have built in a course, and that's what basically is demanded. As I mentioned, I have been using some of these technologies in my teaching, helping students, and also using these technologies to enrich my own personal experiences. And I'm sure many of you do the same. And such platform, when they provide opportunity for all of us to come together, sharing these expertise and experiences, is a great event, and I congratulate Dr. Karad to take a lead in hosting such events. And before I conclude, I just like to say that technology sometimes is also used as a barrier. Embrace this, embrace the technology as a change. The two lines one scholar said, and that's what is happening because of technology. If you don't use technology in your education, what may happen? Sirf kahin dur na ho jaye manzil sirf do kadam rukne se. If you don't use technology, dur na ho jaye manzil sirf do kadam rukne se. Yaad rakhiye, musafir hi nahi, raaste bhi chalte hain. Be aware of the changing environment. Thank you.
What a wonderful speech. A big round of applause, my friends, for Dr. Sushil Sharma. A big round of applause, isn't it? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.